human rights to be followed then by the core issues, trust, and I would ask you to kindly respect for 3 minutes.
Thank you, Madam Moderator. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ahmad Shahidov. I represent Azerbaijan. Also, I represent Azerbaijan. I would like to talk about that, and as a society whose rights are violated. As human rights advocate, we are obliged to support human rights wherever we are. Today, I want to talk about the human rights in Cyprus Island. There are two de facto campuses in Cyprus. One of them is the Republic of Cyprus. I mean, Greek Cyprus. We have the campus representative here. Another campus is the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus, which was ruled by Turks who lived in the island. If we make comparison between the two countries, we observe the rights of Turks in Cyprus are violated. However, these two nations had joint country in 1960. The reason of collapse of this joint state is Greek side, I think. As time passes on, Greeks forced Turks to leave the island, and today they announce themselves as the only owner of the Cyprus. I would like to address to the representative of the Republic of Cyprus. Do you represent Girne, Lefke, Malbusa cities as well? Do you represent Turks who live in the island? If so, why do you violate their rights? The things I observed in Cyprus terrified me indeed. Turks who live in the island are restricted to use their rights for freedom of movement. Hundreds of people live in a blockade in their own country and cannot travel abroad. As sportsmen, scientists, and scholars of Cyprus Turks cannot demonstrate his talent in an international level. The reason is that the country he lives, they live in face sanctions. Today, the negotiations are underway of annexation of the island, and we support these negotiations. However, we observe non-constructive stance of Greek side. When I was in the island, I learned that Greek government handed out hunting weapons to its citizens, and Greeks threatened Turks with these weapons by forcing them to leave their homes. I think this is not peaceful negotiation. I have studied Cyprus history and reached such a conclusion that Greeks have never interested in annexation of the island and its becoming one country. The referendum on Kofi Annan's plan for the reunification of Cyprus, which held in 2004, once again proved this. Also, Turks in the island said yes to the plan. Greeks said no. Greece wants to be the only owner of the island which conducts all international laws. Just imagine over the centuries two nations used to live together, Turks and Greeks. As time passes on, Greeks want to force Turks in the island by the support of Greece and other European countries. Turks who resisted and tried to support their rights, which led to Greek old war. Thousands of people lost their lives. Even today we come across beach where Turks were buried in Cyprus. Who will be responsible for this? I would like to address to the representatives who represent themselves at the Republic of Cyprus here. You do not join this discussion before. Maybe you answer my questions. Why you create obstacles to the negotiation of the annexation of the island? Or you will just fight claims of people during all this time? In conclusion, let me address to the attendees here. We discuss here human rights, especially in Ukraine. It would be appropriate if you make time and visit the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus. Interact with ordinary people. You will see how thousands of people became strangers in their own country, how they face sanctions in their own country. Then you will remember what are indeed the human rights. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much for your contribution. I will now pass on the floor